And Texas is on the call, man. Tex says, welcome to the truth will make you mad. Warning, you might get mad before you walk the court. Go ahead, Tex says.
Hi there. Thanks for having me on.
Whoa. This is a female, man.
I thought it was a man.
I thought it was a guy too, man.
How are you guys doing today?
We're good, sis.
Yeah, I've been watching you for probably a couple of years now, and first of all, let me thank you, because I gotta turn off my other computer. Getting a little feedback. Do you know how to stop the feedback?
You gotta log up to YouTube. Or just totally mute the YouTube.
It. Okay, hang on, let me turn that off. All right, let's see. Is that any better?
Yeah, it's better.
Perfect. Okay. So because of you, I am a secured party creditor. Thank you.
But you're welcome. So you sound very eloquent, but you were using all that broken English in the chat.
Well, no, that was intentional. So if we look at the like Black Law and everything, whoa, man, it's kind of a play on words, because you know, they've broken us apart into being two separate entities, and you know, man, woman, female, and the female male words, if you look up the definition of fee, it means below. So female means below male. So that's why I say whoa, man, because it's woe to the man. And you know, this is from all biblical stuff where they talk about,
yeah, woe to the man. What do you mean by that, woe to the man?
Not woe in that sense. So it's
no. There's only one definition for woe. That's destruction. I don't get what you're saying.
Well, so if you look at the women, and I'm gonna get some slack for this from the ladies. I know, but women should be a little subservient to men because they are our protectors, first of all.
Well, why aren't you taking into consideration of the definition you just explained?
Woe to the man.
I'd rather use woman instead of female.
I don't use the word female, because female, if you will look it up, that was a ship designation of people, of passengers on ships.
Okay.
So that's where that originated. And fee is a Latin based word that means below or subservient to. Okay. So it means subservient to male.
I thought you were implying that you would not like the idea of being subservient to a man, and you would more resonate with the woe man, because woe is the man. That sounded kind of awesome.
You guys took it the wrong way. I was actually a stay-at-home wife with two kids, and so I kind of have a different take on what you guys are saying. I was assaulted while breastfeeding by my husband because I was on Facebook. And so it's just, you guys come across today, earlier today, you guys come across like you were, you know, kind of like bashing women. And I can't generalize that y'all were bashing everybody, but that's how it came across. And it's funny that when I put those words, you guys thought I was doing the exact opposite. So it's interesting. Everything's perception.
Okay, let me ask you a question, sis. Hold on, what exactly did we say that seemed to have been a bash on women? Cite some examples.
So I'm trying to remember, because I've had some calls between when I was on, and I haven't been watching you guys the whole time. I just kind of logged back in, but I remember y'all saying something like, oh, what was it? I'm trying to remember what you guys were talking about. Is there any way, can y'all go back into the chat? Is there any way anyone can scroll back? Because there were like a couple of things you were talking about, and it just seemed like you were like hating on women. But you
made the statement, so you should be able to support that.
Right. No, so it's like you were saying something like, what was it that you were talking about?
It's an indication of something that's ongoing, right? So you should be able to excite at least one or two examples of this bashing.
Right. I'm trying to remember what you guys were saying specifically, so I can bring it up, because I could just pull something out of my hat, but I don't want to do that. I'm trying to remember what you guys are talking about. It just, y'all came across that you were bashing women. And it could be because I was watching another one of y'all's calls where you're talking about how men should have all these wives and how that's biblical. And
we never said that. We never said there's no call that we said men should have. See, you're exaggerating. There's no call ever that we said men should have all of these wives. What we state is that a man is entitled to more than one wife if that is his choice. We're not telling no man to have, that's that man's choice. And if that man could actually afford to be in that particular position, you see, that's an extreme exaggeration right there.
Well, you guys were saying that it's biblical that men should have multiple wives.
No, we didn't say that he should. We said that he could. Those words carry totally different meanings.
You're right. They do. So perhaps I missed that particular word. That would be crucial, a crucial difference. And, but you guys were talking about how, and I was quoting scriptures and you guys went into, I think, what is it? The Patreon or something, whatever the, you know, the back room, because you can't talk a lot about a lot of stuff on YouTube without them tearing us down and trying to manipulate stuff. So anyway,
you're talking about Rumble, that we went over to Rumble.
Rumble. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Right. Yeah. The platform names sometimes fail me. But yeah, it's interesting because like women are taught these days, and here's the problem. It's not with you guys. And I hope women can remember that when we go into this, when we go into that, I hope I could say this word on YouTube, boss B, you know, the boss B, I'm a boss B. Well, when you go into that mentality, you go in thinking that you're not going to be in a partnership ever with a man because they're subservient. And how can a man step into a male role if you think of them as subservient? You know, like these bottom dwellers, but it also takes the flip side. If men think that, and y'all kind of just flipped up my opinion of what y'all are talking about right now with what you were saying about when women act trashy and it step into a male role, that men can't be a man if women are acting like men. So like women have to be feminine for the men to be masculine. And I just think that's beautiful that y'all touched on that, because that really changed my thinking. Because earlier, it really came across that y'all were bashing women, and you know, maybe I mistook it, which is fine.
And that's what I'm concerned about, sis, because that's not how we want to come across.
Yeah.
You see, so and this is why I'm asking you. You see, you're called upon to cite some examples, but you're not able to do that. And so this is how you know women get men locked up because of stuff like that, by exaggerating things, saying a man did a certain thing. And he didn't do it. And now there's this false narrative being pushed against the man because we don't bash women over here. We tell, look, were you listening to the sister that was just on here?
No, I was on all these conference calls and then I came back on and y'all were still here. So I was like, and y'all were talking about in a totally different fashion, that's why I love this channel, because it helps me to see so many different perspectives of, you know, because we come into every situation with a perspective in a sense, in a brainwashing. So we come in with this angle. And if we can't be open, like myself, to all angles, like we'll miss it sometimes, or if we only get bits and pieces. And that's why I didn't want to cite something if I'm not certain. I'm not going to give you an example unless I know for sure.
But you've already put out a certain narrative, but it was bashing females. And so I wanted to touch on those points to clear it up, make it abundantly clear that we're not a bashing women. See, the only people the only women that's offended by this channel is women that these things apply to. You see?
Well, if you were breastfeeding and got attacked by someone and then they run a false narrative, it's going to give you a slightly different perspective on what you guys are talking about.
Let me ask you this. Yeah. The man that you was breastfeeding, were you breastfeeding your baby by him?
Yeah, he was laying next to us.
All right. So was that a baby that you had by him?
Absolutely. In wedlock.
Okay. Let me ask you this. Did you have a responsibility in the decision-making process to choose the right kind of man? Or was it that he forced you to have a baby by him? Did he rape you? Did this guy rape you that you had this baby by?
Not that time.
Okay, so that means you're responsible as well for making a bad decision of getting involved with this kind of man and not really courting him until before you spread it your quiver and decided to birth a child by a man that was abusive. Because one thing that I've learned for certain is that people always give us an indication of who they are, but sometimes we'll ignore that and then we suffer the consequences and we want to blame them. One thing that I've learned to do in life, everything that's happened to me, I know that that could not have actually occurred unless my decision-making process was in it, unless it was like something I couldn't control, like someone just like running in back of me in a car. But if I had a choice in that process, am I not partially responsible?
Right. So
then
here's
you're
the
responsible
deal.
For getting with a man like that.
And here's the deal. If the man you are with has a traumatic brain injury from a rollover car accident and becomes a different man and becomes abusive in that situation, you're going to make me cry because you're right. Like the slow changes that he turned into, I had a choice to stay with him because I honored our marriage vow. I honored that. And I didn't know he was physically dangerous until the day he assaulted me while I was breastfeeding and also injured our baby. So, you know, that was the day that I showed this is enough, you know, like my babies are in jeopardy.
Right.
But you guys have to remember that there are incidences where someone can be injured and their personality can change. Or even if someone's abusing some sort of substance, even these energy drinks can alter people's brains these days. And so it's like people can change, and then you're right. They do have subtle tip offs when they're changing. And if you ignore the signs, you know, that's your fault too.
Let me ask you this.
Yeah.
So this just rolls up in a vacuum. This man never gave you, just one day he just attacked you while he was breastfeeding like a maniac. He never gave you any indication. There was no arguing back and forth. There was no signs in his body language that this man might hit you one day. This just rose in a vacuum.
So after his rollover car accident, he was in a lot of pain. And he kind of just started like pulling away. Yeah, I mean, it was slow and gradual. It's like the frog in the hot water thing. It was so gradual that I didn't pay enough attention because, you know, I had an infant that I was breastfeeding and another child, you know, so it was so slow that, you know,
I seemed as though you're tap dancing around my question. So my question is, again, I'm going to make it abundantly clear.
Okay.
Did he not give you any indication that this could possibly escalate? Because there's very few situations that happen like that, right? That someone just for no reason just come up and attack you. There's usually an exchange of words or something. He loses control and then it happens.
Yeah. That's what I'm laying down in the bed and he wanted my phone and that's how it happened. So yes, but he didn't escalate to the point where I thought he would crush my phone in half, fling our daughter across the room, and then, you know, do the rest of the things, which I'm not going to go into. But
so let me ask you this.
No, he didn't have, I never got any inclination that it would go that far from him.
So I'm asking you this, Texas. Why did he want your phone?
Because he thought I was cheating, because he was cheating on me. He thought I was cheating on him. So he wanted my phone.
So now we have it. Now we have it. So if he thought that, then this was actually a man that thinks a woman is cheating is usually very NC. Usually,
well, he's usually right. I'm sorry. I mean, I'm interrupting you, but he's usually right.
What was that?
Did you say he's usually right?
I don't know how you got that from anything that I said.
Oh yeah, that's why I was like,
but no, that's what you want to hear. You see, that's what you anticipated.
No, that's why I'm asking for clarification.
Is that what it sounded like to you guys that I said?
Not at all.
Okay. I didn't hear after you said a man that thinks.
You see what I mean about how women get men in trouble? You see what I'm saying?
I'm asking you for a clarification right now before you, because I don't want to misunderstand you.
Right. So why are you the only one that got that from what I just stated right there?
Why are you offended that I'm asking you to clarify?
No, I'm asking you, why are you the only one that heard that out of the statement that I just made?
I have no idea, but I'm asking you to clarify.
Yeah.
Because I felt like I didn't hear that properly. So I'm asking you to repeat it. That's why I asked it.
Okay. So, and this is what I'm talking about. Things like that leads to problems. Now, you was just about to suggest something that I didn't even say anything close to at all. So why would your brain function like that?
I'm asking you to repeat what you said.
I said NC. I said men are usually NC.
What does that mean?
Go and define it.
Mincy? I'm sorry.
No, I didn't say mincy. See, you're I don't know.
Speaker. It's getting distorted. So I don't understand the word you're saying.
Okay.
What is the word you're saying?
So in layman's terms, it means he's edgy. He's jumpy. He's judgmental.
Okay. Okay, because I heard that totally different. And that's why I stopped you and asked you to clarify, because I don't want to be thinking you said one thing when you didn't. And that's why I stopped you, because I was like, wait, what did you just say? Let me make sure I'm hearing that. Because that's crucial. If you don't hear and then you assume, that's dangerous territory, like you're saying. It's dangerous.
And I've detected that at least 4 times during the Discord of our conversation here today.
At first, you suggested.
See, what you're doing is you're putting out a narrative, right? You're painting a certain paradigm, but you're presuming innocence, right? Initially, you painted a paradigm that we was bashing women, and I asked you to cite a couple of things, but you couldn't do it. Right. Even though that you put that out there. See, when you say certain words, then you're creating a particular narrative. Right. So now you put it out there. The listeners are hearing this, but you can't justify why you said that.
I can go back and look through the comments right when I commented. It'll be right there. But it's confusing to me that when I ask you to clarify what you said, instead of just simply clarifying, you go into an argument.
It's not an argument. Why would you say that? For something to be an argument, that has to be contention. You see? And still, you know what you're trying to do? Instead of acknowledging that you made an accusatory statement, is that you're trying to shift and say, well, it's your fault, because you wouldn't go back and restate it, even though that everyone else on the call heard me.
No, so the second part just now, when I asked you to re-say what you just said, instead of simply repeating right off the bat, like you assumed that I was arguing with you.
No, I never mentioned the word argument. Look how you're reaching now. I never mentioned the word argument whatsoever. I asked you, I returned, my response was a question, which why would you suggest that based on what I said? That's what I said.
And I did say it comes across that way. It came across that way. But that's why I like having this discourse, because, you know, you can communicate with people and like ask them, look, this is what I'm hearing. Is this what you mean? And I think that's crucial and that's why I still enjoy watching your show, is because, you know, you'll kind of go back and forth with people and like, okay, this makes sense. If this is how I heard it, but that's not what you meant. And I think a lot of things are misconstrued by a lot of people. When people can go in with assumptions when that's not how they were planned to be said. Does that make sense?
What happens is a lot of people listen to things with a certain mindset already playing out as to what they expect the person is saying, what they convey the message to be. And instead of listening with open ears, they're literally listening according to their emotions. And that's right. What makes a person assume that a person is attacking or assume this or assume that, when at the end of the day, you would literally have to understand that we're men of the Most High. We not the guy who attacked you, you know, while you was breastfeeding or whatnot. So when we say certain things, you have to understand that this message is coming from the men of the Most High. So it's not to say as, oh, we here bashing women or nothing like that. So it shouldn't come off in that manner. We're simply here men who've decided to take a stand for masculinity of men.
And I fully support the masculinity of women.
And we here to correct our women and call them out on the ways that they have made mistakes and things of that nature. Yet the women are so masculine that they're not even receptive to the message that we convey.
And that's what I was talking about. These women, right. Like what I was saying, that women come in with that boss bee, I'm the boss. And I'm like, it's so damaging that we got the roles reversed and society's perpetuating women being masculine. And it's so frustrating. And I hope I didn't cut you off just then. Thank you for clarifying, because it did come across so wrong. And when I was calling in right now, y'all were like talking about it in a different fashion, and it made sense the way you're talking about it this time, the way your purpose behind your conveying of what you're saying right now made sense to me this time. Before, it seemed completely opposite of what the purpose. Does that make sense? And I'm going to have to go back. I'm going to go back and rewatch all of it, because I found that productive, revisiting a situation. And, you know, people have these arguments or whatever. Sorry to use the word argument, because then I know how he is creating controversy is by using the word argument. We don't want to argue. So that's a poor choice of words. But
no, is good. Argument is not good. To argue comes from the Latin word to make clear. An argument is not good.
Correct. I love it. I love that you like the Latin too. I think we gotta teach more Latin and more, you know, women being feminine and more men being masculine. And how do you guys feel about these men that are trying to be more feminine? Like, and then they get mad when a woman is trying to be masculine. I'm like,
what do you mean by that? Like, which men?
So this will touch on where, you know, my husband was not, he wasn't stepping into the man role. And I was asking him and talking to you guys right now, it makes me see more how I could have really handled a lot of things differently. And like, I would ask him, I'm like, I want you to be the leader. And he would get mad. He wanted someone more like a mother. And I didn't want to be his mother. I wanted to be a partner, but then also, you know, to step back and have him lead. And that made him irate, because he would just suppress all these feelings instead of talking about them or just, you know, stepping into the leadership role. He wanted me to do everything. And that's exhausting, you know, for a woman who is breastfeeding, and you want me to be a stay-at-home wife and a mother and sit here and do these subservient things, then you want me to actually run the whole plan. I'm like, you can't do both. And, you know, I think that's, y'all touch on this a lot, is that these women get crazy and they want a man to be a man, but then they want to act like a man, and we give them nowhere to go. We give you guys nowhere to go if we step into the man role, you know, like, but same goes for both sides. You know, when a man steps into a female role or a feminine role, the girl has nowhere to go if she's truly in her feminine.
I'm hit you with a few interrogatories. First of all, where can I call you besides Texas? I'm not too favorable of Texas. I like to be on a, what was that?
Taylor.
A surname, huh? It's still not as personal, because I don't like to talk at people. I like to talk to them. But nevertheless, Taylor, so what exactly is the criteria that you use when you're determining what a man is? Like, when you say he was into his feminine, right?
Right.
He's getting more feminine. Now, I'm going to ask you this. What did you do wrong in a relationship Why did you not? Did this femininity surface after the traumatic event, or was it always present there?
So, I mean, it used to be. He used to be super masculine. You know, he would open the door for me, you know, step up and do the really old school, like, gentleman type thing.
Hold on a second.
Okay.
So, you believe that a man opening a door for a woman is masculine?
I think that's masculine. For okay, me, I do.
How is that masculine? Listen, let me tell you. See, your mom is a perfect. That right there is a perfect example of feminism on steroids. Now, what makes you believe a man opening a door for a woman is masculine? Is that not him submitting to that woman?
Romantic.
Well, I don't see that as submission. I see that as him protecting me from a heavy door.
That's your logic, right? So let's look at it from a factual perspective, right? Okay. Let's say a man's a king, right? Right. And one man's a pheasant, right? When the king walks, will another man open the door? Let's say the president. Let's use Joe Biden, right? Does other men open a door for Joe Biden? Yes, they do. See, you don't want to answer that because now you're on the spot, right? But yes, they do. Why?
Why? I just answered it.
Why? Because he's the dominant figure of those relationships around him. Because he's... Let me finish. He's the dominant figure of those around him. So they do this because he's the king. They call him a president now because the United States is a company. But in reality, he's the king of this corporation, of this company, right? So he get men open a door for him. They open a car for him. They chauffeur him around. And those men that do this for him, would you say that they're his superior or his subordinates?
Those are his employees that are subordinate.
Yeah, they're subordinates. So a man that opens a door for a woman is placing himself in a subordinate position. If he constantly does that, and she never opens the door for him. You understand that?
Well, you assumed, you made an assumption that's
the case. No, I didn't make an assumption. I made a statement.
Let me ask you this. Should a woman hold the door for the man then?
Yeah, she should.
Really, a woman that can't physically open a door.
Now you're playing something else. You play a lot of semantics, man. You play a lot of semantics. I'm listening to your conversation. So now you're saying, now look at the semantics you're just trying to play. You asked me, should a woman open a door for a man? Then you say that cannot physically open a door for a man.
Well,
those are two different types of women right there.
So, no, I can't open a lot of doors. So, but I should work out and exercise so I can open a door for a man.
Listen, you know what? You're single right now, right? Are you single right now?
That's none of your business.
Yeah, you're going to stay single. You're going to stay where you are until you find a loser that's willing to be with a woman like you. Because wow. Right now, you came on here with a certain persona, but it's really not you. Because when I put you on the spot and you expose your true character just like the others, come on. You're pretending that you're different, but you're really not. Now, if my son, who's 3 years old, can open a door, you're telling me you can't open a door? Give me a damn break, man.
Wow. The fact of that you're getting so agitated when I ask you to clarify and you don't, and then you say that a woman who can't physically open a door should open a door for a man, and then that's... You guys are confused. You don't seem to understand yourselves what masculine and feminine
is. You can't make this up, man. You cannot make this up.
You can't.
So
because he's not putting you on a pedestal, then...
I'm glad people get to witness this. I'm glad people get to witness this, man. I'm glad people get to witness this.
What does con mean? What is the guy that...
None of your business. It means none of your business.
Con.
It means none of your business.
Are you just conning people? It's the con. You're conning them.
It means none of your business.
So now you're insulting them because your true character is coming out. What does that say about that?
No, you're the one that's saying con, so I'm asking you. I'm asking you, the one that says con.
Crazy. And they're a full 360.
You see what I mean, guys?
It's funny because you guys.
You see what I mean?
You think that I'm single because you assume that because you have so much rage inside of you.
Another one bites the dust.
I wonder what she would assume when we say la-a.
But hey, listen. This is why you got to probe and get the true meaning. You know what? I guarantee this woman done something to get that man locked up.
Facts.
That's why you see how she just kind of exaggerating things. She first said, "Do you believe a woman should open the door?" Yes. Then she switched it and say, "So you're telling me a woman that can't physically open a door should open a door for a man?" Yeah, that is witchcraft all day long.
Con, right. Because that's like some Dungeons and Dragons stuff she just pulled on you, because she's like basically changing the story as it goes along after you answered it. That's like me saying, like, well, does that mean a woman should open the door for a man? Okay, well, that woman has no arms. It's just like, well,
yeah,
why didn't you? You should have prefaced that. It's not exactly the same thing. Cannot open a door means
yeah,
you
and
have
I'm
no
telling
arms.
You, man, I tell you, it is my belief, my opinion. Based on what she just exhibited here, she provoked that guy to do something. She's not innocent in that situation, huh? You understand what I'm saying?
I believe you. No, I don't.
Because look how she came on the call. Look how she came on the call making accusatory statements that she could not justify with one example. Not one. I tell you, man, I throw these women out and I expose them.
Remember, she said she was on Facebook before the dude to us so-called assaulted her, right? I wonder what she was doing on the Facebook.
I noticed how she tried to go against it, then she'll come back and agree with it to try to like smooth things out and then switch the narrative again.
No, she's crazy. She was trying to be an agent. That's basically how it was operating, because she obviously didn't agree, but then she would agree just to see how far she could keep the conversation going. So she's wasting her own time. And that obfuscation she pulled about how, oh, well, she can't physically open the door. Now, and then she's just rambling at that point, because at no point was that the question that you had answered. Yeah, well, should a woman open the door for a man?
And I'm going to hit you with something. Whenever you put your bass in your voice like me, they call it rage. They call it toxic masculinity. I call it being a real man, and it's not going to change.
Come on. Oh, man. What? What a show.
And then because she's hurt, she wants to throw the insults.
Yeah, wow. Man. Listen.
Can I make it up?
Sitting in there on Facebook.
That man, you peeped that, right, Shakaria? You peeped that.
Yeah, she tried to flip it back on you. What's con mean? Because you felt some type of way. Now you want to make an insult to try to one up you. Wow. That's crazy.
You can't make this stuff up. You can't.
You can't.
Also, yeah. And then she was also, another thing that she was doing, she's being very arbitrary, because in one case, she's telling us everything, every intricate thing about her personal life, and now all of a sudden her marital status is private. You just told us that the man that allegedly hit you. Yeah, go ahead, forgive me.
And now it's none of your business.
That's because wow, she's alone, man. There is no man there, man. It's common sense, man. Ain't nobody finna put up with that foolishness, man.
I mean, just the first few minutes, I detected how this woman was lying. And I said it, she's the kind of woman that does these things and say they get men locked up or for lies up.
Huh.
Avoid a woman like that at all costs, because she will get you locked up by lying. That woman, she lied at least 5 times during the duration of her call, by head. Making 4 statements. Everyone else heard exactly what I said. And she said, oh, well, you probably were cheating. Is that what you said? That and Kadar hit the nail on the head. At that point, I stopped responding to it, because I already know she didn't really want to hear the truth, right? So I go silent. Kadar said, you know, some people come on with a certain, you know, mindset. And that's exactly what it was. She heard what she wanted to hear.
Oh.
You can't help someone like that.
And Dilla, I even peeped this. You remember how she was like, I'm a secured party creditor because of you. So I listen to everything and take mental notes. Then at the end, she's going to, what's the con mean? I mean, you're conning people? Whoa, you just said you basically just admitted you received the secured party creditor package from him. You're congratulating him. Now he's a con.
Right.
Man, listen.
How does that make sense?
Calls long enough. Ain't no way in the world you don't know what con means.
Yeah.
Con is stated on every show at a minimum of 100 times.
Con. Boy, I love it. I love it, man. I love the energy, man. The troop is coming out, huh?
And another proof of her masculine energy was just the way that she was using the keyboard. Remember when she was in the text? Remember when she was chatting? We were all for certain that was a man. For sure. Everyone thought. Everyone on the call, if you were listening and you were reading Texas's messages, you wouldn't say, oh, that's definitely a woman writing those messages. No, you didn't think that because you thought it was a man writing those messages.
We all thought it was a man. We all did.
Yeah, because it was aggressive and accusatory and angry and everything that she was like saying is projections of her own, basically her own personality. Because the same way that she's saying that, you know, I don't know exactly how she said it. You know, you're being aggressive or whatever. But that's really her, because she kept on making accusations to every answer that you would give. She would twist your answer to be, well, now she's now in this case, the woman has no arms or can't open a door, can't open a door. Like, I want to show you how foolish I use that image of a woman with no arms, but like to not be able to physically open a door means you have no hands, you have no arms, you have a broken arm. Like, yeah, obviously, if she broke her arm and I'm picking her up from the hospital, yeah, I'll hold the door for you. Yeah, sure. Hey, that's different than you.
My son is 3 years old, three years old, and he opened doors. Come on, man. Come on, man. That kind of woman right there is nothing but a problem. Avoid her at all costs. And she will remain alone unless some bozo go in and he gets involved in that. This is why you got to screen him. I'm telling you, see, notice I wasn't agreeing with her. See, I didn't take in account any of the so-called compliments that she was trying to give me, because I know they're all BS. You cannot run those games on me, man. Let's deal with the facts here. Why? Well, I couldn't hear you. Why you have a problem repeating it? Because I don't have to. That's why. Because I don't have to. The more interesting concept was, how did you hear that? From saying that men that's doing that are usually NC. How do you get, like, he was probably right. They don't even sound like that. Hey, you probably was cheating. How do you get that from that?
Not even close.
That's that's actually a symptom of like, and it's that symptom is an auditory hallucination. She hallucinated what you said. There's no way that you said that. So her mind completed the sentence in her own head, and that could be brought on from a myriad of things, man. Drugs, food, dehydration, listen, man, a lot of things.
I'll be forced to say it, man. Any man that beats a woman, he needs his ass beaten. And especially if you take your own child and throw him against the room, he needs to be dealt with. You see what I'm saying? He needs to be dealt with on a physical level, right? But my thing that she didn't want to talk about, where were you? What did you do wrong in this? Uh-huh. You see what I'm saying? I mean, man, you think I'm stupid enough to believe that if the man, let's say the man had a traumatic brain injury, right? It would no longer be his fault. Because he's no longer in control of his brain. You understand what I'm saying? So now you have to discern whether or not you're going to remain with this guy, right? But the woman is shifting the blame on the man again, utterly, and she had no involvement. I said, well, was this guy? No, he was very masculine in the beginning. You see how she had a lie for everything up? So the brain damage caused a man to be effeminate. It caused a man to be a violent maniac, and so on and so forth.
She ain't did nothing.
She done nothing. She did absolutely nothing.
See how they like to feign innocence, right? They hide behind it, like, oh, he was here. They come in here, they tell all their stories, and it's always the man was the problem, the man was the problem, the issue. But they can't last, 10 minutes with their story on here before they get exposed.
I just think that the whole setup, the moment I started to distrust her was when she said that thing about the rollover. And I was like, well, and I'm thinking like, oh yeah, how could you paint this picture better? How can you not take a single ounce of responsibility? Because, and you know, there are situations where someone's 100% responsible for something, but there is some give and take in all situations. You know, you gotta like, what led up to these circumstances? At some point, you can't say, well, it was 100% their fault. That does happen 100% of the time. Sometimes, like an accident, there is times where that. But at the same time, you're still in that situation to have that accident happen to you. You know what I'm saying? So there is still some responsibility to be shed.
But she didn't want to get into it. She didn't want to get into the fact that she provoked some kind of reaction from that.
Another thing she said. Was that, you know, all y'all, like she said it to me too, like, because I'm everyone on this call, I didn't say anything during the whole time that she was talking. I let her talk until we were done with her, because then she has then she wants to accuse all of us on the call, even people who aren't saying anything, of basically come like being against her. That's a certain personality type right there, because
narcissism, man. What? Feminism, narcissist.
Huh. It's crazy.
Though. I don't want to take responsibility.
She still ain't state nothing about if you married, right, and you just had and you breastfeeding your child. What are you even doing on Facebook? What you doing? That'll make a man want to see your phone. What you doing? Or what have you got caught doing in the past?
Listen, man, this is the fact. Here's a fact. She said that he thought I was cheating because he was cheating. This is what I'm saying. Now, this is how you know her whole story was bullshit. A man with traumatic brain injuries out there cheating. He knows enough to be out there with cheating with other women. But all of a sudden, he became extremely effeminate. He's violent, but he's out there cheating with some other woman. Come on, man.
None of it add up.
None of it makes sense at all.
Lie them, I tell you, no?
He have traumatic brain injury.
Damn,
bro. Yeah, man. It took off of the call when she started to get belligerent. Second one removed today. Now we're waiting for Sinai. Sinai, come on the call. Sinai Renee, next up. Come on the call, Sinai. Out of three of them, one of them has to be good. See, this is what I'm telling you guys, man. Try every spirit. If you guys listen, you're going to see what I mean. Just disagree with them. You see, the problem here is that I didn't agree with either of them today. You see what I'm saying? Oh, there she goes, Sinai Renee. I didn't agree with either of them today, and they don't like that. They can't handle that when you disagree with them. Thanks. A woman is used. Most of these women are accustomed to men always agreeing and bowing down to them. Now think about how ridiculous that is. The man's going to open the door for her. She doesn't want to open the door for him. I'm not from Rome. I'm not romantic. That's European society. Let me ask you guys this. You're calling yourself Malak, right? That's the Paleo-Hebrew word for king. Does a king go open the door for a queen? No.
Not at all.
No. Everyone bows to the king. That's what you got to understand, man. You're a man. That's what a king is. Not every man could be a king. And this society has turned most men into pheasants. Sinai Renee, welcome to the Truth Will Make You Mad, sis. Two angry birds for today. And I don't know how long you've been on, but the subject matter, sis, is why does average women want men far above in a sense of value? Why do they?